I made a mistake with you, letting you speak in front of my classroom and spew your propaganda. Well, today, we're gonna change things up a bit.
Evil. Now, it's been said that evil is atheism's most potent weapon against the Christian faith, and it is. After all, the very existence of evil begs the question, if God is all good, and God is all powerful, why does he allow evil to exist? The answer at its core is remarkably simple. Free will. God allows evil to exist because of free will. From the Christian standpoint, God tolerates evil in this world on a temporary basis, so that one day those who choose to love him freely will dwell with him in heaven, free from the influence of evil, but with their free will intact. In other words, God's intention concerning evil is to one day destroy it.
Well, how convenient. One day, I will get rid of all the evil in the world. But until then, you just have to deal with all the wars and Holocaust, tsunamis, poverty, starvation, and AIDS. Have a nice life.
Next, you'll be lecturing us on moral absolutes.
But why not? Professor Radisson, who's clearly an atheist, doesn't believe in moral absolutes. But his course syllabus says he plans to give us an exam during finals weeks. Now, I'm betting that if I manage to get an A in the exam by cheating, he'll suddenly start sounding like a Christian, insisting it's wrong to cheat, that I should have known that. And yet, what basis does he have? If my actions are calculated to help me succeed, then why shouldn't I perform them? For Christians, the fixed point of morality, what constitutes right and wrong, is a straight line that leads directly back to God.
Oh, so you're saying that we need a God to be moral, that a moral atheist is an impossibility.
No, but with no God, there's no real reason to be moral. I mean, there's not even a standard of what moral behavior is. For Christians, lying, cheating, stealing, in my example, stealing a grade I didn't earn are forbidden. It's a form of theft. But if God does not exist, as Dostoevsky famously pointed out, if God does not exist, then everything is permissible.
And not only permissible,
but pointless. If Professor Radisson is right, then all of this, all of our struggle, our debate, whatever we decide here is meaningless. I mean, our lives and ultimately our deaths are no more consequence than that of a goldfish.
Well, this is ridiculous. So after all your talk, you're saying that it all comes down to a choice. Believe or don't believe.
That's right. That's all there is. That's all there's ever been. The only difference between your position and my position is that you take away their choice. You demand that they choose the box marked, I don't believe.
Yes, because I want to free them. Because religion is like it's like a mind virus that parents have passed on down to their children. And Christianity is the worst virus of all. It slowly creeps into our lives when we're weak or sick or helpless.
So religion is like a disease?
Yes. Yes, it infects everything. It's the enemy of reason.
Reason? Professor, you left reason a long time ago. What you're teaching here isn't philosophy. It's not even atheism anymore. What you're teaching is anti-theism. It's not enough that you don't believe. You need all of us to not believe with you.
Why don't you admit the truth? You just want to ensnare them in your primitive superstition.
What I want is for them to make their own choice. That's what God wants.
You have no idea how much I'm going to enjoy failing you.
Yeah, but who are you really looking to fail, Professor? Me? Or God? Do you hate God?
It's not even a question.
Okay. Why do you hate God?
This is ridiculous.
Why do you hate God? Answer the question. You've seen the science and the arguments. Science supports his existence. You know the truth. So why do you hate him? Why? It's a very simple question, Professor. Why do you hate God?
Because he took everything away from me. Yes, I hate God. All I have for him is hate.
How can you hate someone if they don't exist?
You've proven nothing.
Maybe not. They get to choose. Is God dead? God is not dead. God's not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead.
God's not dead.